Hi, friend. I'm so glad you're here today because I'm talking about one of my absolute favorite topics. It's all about niching down because this has the biggest impact on your yoga business, I pinky promise. But I also know that this decision comes with a lot of resistance too, because trust me, I resisted it for over a year. But hang in there with me because I'm going to make it as easy as possible for you to take the leap. Welcome to episode number 2 of the Marketing Yoga with Confidence podcast. I'm your host, Amanda McKinney. I'm a marketing coach for yoga teachers, and this podcast was created for you, my dear yoga teacher friend who feels icky when it comes to the idea of marketing yourself, but you're also really ready to grow your yoga business. My goal is to remind you that what you're doing is amazing so that you have more confidence in marketing yourself, and I also share an actionable step so you can move forward in marketing your yoga. This episode is brought to you by my membership, Marketing Yoga with Confidence. It's a place where the members receive not only step-by-step tutorials for marketing tactics, but also monthly Q&A calls, a private community, and lots of encouragement. Use the link in the show notes to get on the waitlist or join the membership today. So let's jump right into today's episode all about niching down in your yoga business. I'm so excited to talk to you about one of my absolute favorite topics, and that's your dream student. So let's take an imaginary journey and walk into your dream class that's filled with your dream students. And this happens week after week, and your students can't help but invite other people because they just love your class. Isn't that an incredible dream? This can actually happen, but we often miss this as yoga teachers because we're a little uncomfortable with the idea of narrowing down our focus and really niching down. And this comes from such a sweet place because it comes from not wanting to exclude anyone, because yoga is for everyone. But the reality is that if you try to speak to everyone, you actually speak to no one. And that is not what I want for you. What I want for you is to tap into what really lights you up, and I want you to teach that thing. Whether it's hip-hop yoga to grandmas, or children's yoga, or private sessions for couples, what is the class that you can't help but smile when you know you're going to be teaching? When I say, give me an example of one of your students, who do you think of? This can tell you so much about where your true yoga passion lies. And that's what I want you to tap into so you can teach more of that thing. That is my dream for you. And we can get you there if you're willing to push past that initial discomfort just a little bit. And once you are, the best news is that marketing actually gets much easier. But all of this being said, there is a caveat to this statement. If you've just graduated from yoga teacher training and aren't quite sure who your dream student is, then I want you to continue to say yes to all the opportunities that come your way, because this is how you will figure it out. The more you experience, the closer you will get to knowing who your dream student really is. But if you're ready to truly niche down, then I have a great tool for you. I have a free guide that you can find at marketingyogawithconfidence.com/podcast that will literally walk you through the questions to help you identify who your dream student is. And once you've narrowed down, the sky's the limit. You can take this and run with it. There will likely be a transition period where you're still teaching a variety of things, but slowly you can replace those classes and clients with more of your dream classes and clients. And trust me, it's possible because I've seen it so many times. But it all comes down to making that decision that niching down is more than okay, that it's awesome, but it will be a process. And this process will take time, but if you know your passion, then you will make it happen. And I want to give you a few examples of how I've witnessed this happen, and then I want you to get that free guide so you can dig a little deeper into this for yourself. And the first example is actually my own. And if you listened to the first episode of my podcast, then you know that I didn't start my entrepreneurship journey as a marketing coach for yoga teachers. I started as a marketing consultant. I worked with small businesses and corporations. I was all over the map. I said yes to every opportunity that came my way. I mean, I was starting a business just like you. but slowly I realized that I didn't love working with all the businesses and corporations. So I narrowed down to the health and wellness industry, which was still really broad, but I was getting closer. And then one day it hit me like a ton of bricks that my dream student was yoga teachers. I was so nervous to make that leap, but I felt the calling, and so I went with it. And in one day, I changed my website to be all about yoga teachers. I changed it in one day. This is huge, and if you've ever written website copy, then you know this. But the words just came so much easier when I knew exactly who I was speaking to. And another example is one of my students who's been teaching for a little over 5 years. She said yes to all the things for about 4 of those years, maybe a little less. But as soon as we started to work together, she slowly started to narrow down her focus. And it really started with me asking her how much money she wanted to make per month. She did give me a number that day, but later told me that she made the number up and she thought she was aiming too high. But fast forward 6 months from when she told me that number, she was making that amount each month. By setting that goal, she was able to then dig into the numbers, see where she was currently making money and what she enjoyed doing. Because the other question I asked her was, what does your ideal week look like? And her answer included teaching less public classes, but more private sessions. So she started to make that shift. She identified which studios were more in line with what she wanted to teach. So she dropped down from teaching at more than 5 studios to actually teaching at 3. She made this transition slowly, as she would get subs for her classes and then start to talk about her private sessions more. As she gained more private clients, she would let go of another public class. Then she realized that she really enjoyed working with couples. She isn't exclusively only working with couples just yet, but she's talking about this more and more and gaining more of those clients. She's consistently making the money each month that she mentioned to me over a year ago, and I couldn't be more proud of her. She knew it would be a process, and each step makes a big difference. Each time I see an email come through from her and it says, private yoga teacher, under her name, I smile because she is living her dream. And I want you to have this same story. I want you to make it your goal that I will talk about you in a podcast one day, beaming of how proud I am of you. So commit today to taking the leap and making your dream a reality. So your next best step is to download the free guide. Download the guide and go through those questions. If you know who your dream student is after question number 1, then stop there and let's get you started. But if you don't quite get there with question number 1, there's so many more. This guide has so many questions that can walk you through the process so you can feel a little more comfortable narrowing your focus. You can get the guide at marketingyogawithconfidence.com/podcast. So now you know your next best step, and all there's left to do is to take the leap. So let's do this together. Jump in the show notes and download the free guide to help you niche down in your yoga business. There's really no time like the present, and knowing that this is a process should help ease your mind just a little bit. So commit to something specific for the next 6 months and give it a try. If you enjoyed this podcast episode, be sure to hit the subscribe button so you don't miss a single episode. And if you're getting all the feels about this one, be sure to leave a review on the podcast app that you use. That's seriously the best way for me to hear back from you about the episode. Thank you so much for listening to this episode. As you can tell, I really love this topic and know that it will help transform your business. So go get that download today. You can find the link in the show notes at marketingyogawithconfidence.com/podcast. Until next time, give yourself permission to get specific and grace along the way. Talk to you soon.